to take a book of so many pages, if I remember right, 1,200 pages, and translate it into any language is an enormous enterprise. The Russians did this thanks to our colleague Braginsky and his friends in Moscow. But for Braginsky, he put 100 copies of it in the library of his research center, and he had a couple of copies himself. And the last I saw him, he told me, sadly, that they've all disappeared. The people's property, after all. And the people went away with it. But the Chinese, to translate it into Chinese would be something that would be a real enterprise. But the famous dissident Fang Lizhi and his wife now live at the on the campus of the University of Arizona at Tucson. He's teaching, and she, who used to teach physics in Beijing to contribute to physics, decided that she would translate this book into Chinese. But no publisher in mainland China dares do it because of the fact that Fang Lizhi is a famous dissident. So she's getting it published in Taiwan. Well, Taiwan is great. There's a lot of good scientists there. I confess I did not volunteer to check the translation. But when I saw her last some months ago, she was sending through her husband the last bit of manuscript to Taiwan. She checked the last proof. And I said, will this ever reach mainland China? She smiled quietly at me, and she took out a paper napkin and wrote on it, in 2 years, begin smuggle.